Advanced Freemasonry Curse Breaking. Including The Legend of Hiram Abiff, Freemasonry's Story. How Do We Get Free? Scottish Rite York Rite. Physical Diseases. Interconnected Religions and Orders. The Legend of Hiram Abiff. The Blue Lodge is centered upon the legend of Hiram Abiff. This legend has its historical basis in 1 Kings 7 and 2 Chronicles 2. King Hiram of Tyre sent a skilled man, also called Hiram, to Israel, to help King Solomon build the temple of the Lord. If we are to understand many of the degrees of Freemasonry, we must first understand the Masonic legend built around this Hiram Abiff. Let's take a quick glance at it. Remember, this is only a Masonic legend. Legend means non-historical story with no or limited truth. Hiram Abiff, a widow's son from Tyre, skillful in working with all kinds of metals, was employed to help build King Solomon's temple. The legend tells us that one day, while worshipping the grand architect of the universe, Jehovah, within the Holy of Holies, Hiram was attacked by three ruffians, who demanded the Master's word, the secret name of God. The first ruffian, named Jubilah, struck Hiram across the throat with a 24-inch gauge. The second ruffian, named Jubilo, struck Hiram's breast, over the heart, with a square. The third ruffian, named Jubilum, struck Hiram upon the forehead with a gavel, whereupon Hiram fell down dead. His blood, therefore, was shed within the temple. Hiram's body was carried out the east gate of the temple and buried outside Jerusalem on Mount Moriah. Early the following morning, King Solomon visited the temple and found the workmen in confusion because no plans had been made for the day's work. Fearing evil had befallen Hiram, King Solomon sent out 12 fellow craft masons to look for Hiram. King Solomon himself accompanied the three who traveled east. Having finally located the grave of Hiram, Solomon and his fellow masons dug up the body. A search was made for the Master's word, the name of God, but all that was found was the letter G. Discovering the word was lost, a lament went up, "O Lord, my God, is there no help for the widow's son?" Solomon summoned all 12 fellow craft masons, formed a circle around Hiram's body, and attempted to raise him from the grave. They first took hold of Hiram's body with the bow as grip of the first degree. This failed to achieve its purpose. They then repositioned their hold upon Hiram's body using the jachin grip of the second degree. This also failed to accomplish its purpose. Solomon finally raised Hiram from the dead by using the third degree grip of the Master Mason, the 5 points of fellowship, explained shortly, and by uttering in Hiram's ear the phrase Mahabon. Other renditions of the legend of Hiram Abiff leave Hiram in the grave. While the degrees of the Blue Lodge are based upon this part of the legend, the Scottish and York base themselves largely upon the Hiramic legend after Hiram Abiff's resurrection. The Scottish Rite 4th to 1/4 degrees. The legend of Hiram Abiff continues. Hiram Abiff has been raised from the dead. However, he soon leaves the legend, for he has been ushered into a more glorious existence. Solomon is left to continue building the temple. Many decisions have to be made. Solomon first selects 7 expert masons to guard the temple, before holding a requiem for the departed Hiram Abiff. Solomon then appoints 7 judges to hand out justice to the workmen building the temple. 5 superintendents are installed to oversee the continuing building of the temple. Solomon then focuses upon apprehending the assassins of Hiram Abiff. He appoints 9 masters, who begin the search for the assassins. The first assassin is discovered asleep. He is stabbed in the heart and head, then decapitated. Solomon hears a report that the other 2 assassins have fled to Gath, the birthplace of Goliath. Solomon selects 15 masters, including the original 9, who apprehend them. They are placed in prison, and then executed. Solomon rewards 12 of the masters by making them governors over the 12 tribes of Israel. Solomon finally appoints a builder by the name of Adoniram as the sole successor to Hiram Abiff. Adoniram becomes chief architect of the temple, which is finally completed. The legend doesn't stop here, however. Solomon begins to build a temple of justice upon the site of a temple built by Enoch. Remember, this is Masonic legend, not biblical truth, who placed within the temple a stone bearing the name of God. Adoniram, the chief architect, and two other workmen begin building the temple of justice only to discover Enoch's stone. Solomon and Hiram of Tyre, the grand masters of Freemasonry, have little choice but to initiate the three workmen into the secrets of the craft. All three are taught the correct pronunciation of the name of God. Scottish Rite 1/5 to 16th degrees. As the Freemason progresses through the Scottish Rite, 1/5, 16th degrees, the legend of Hiram Abiff continues. The Temple of Solomon was destroyed around 586 BC. The name of God was once again lost. Jerusalem was taken captive, and the Babylonian captivity began. The captives lived in Babylon for 70 years until King Cyrus of Persia, who was a master of Freemasonry, had a dream. He dreamt that a lion appeared to him, saying liberty to the captives. Under the lion's direction, Cyrus proclaimed the release of the Jews. He ordered them to construct a second temple under his guidance. Many of the Jews, especially Nehemiah and Ezra, were initiates of the Masonic mysteries. They directed all the Masons within the midst of the Jews to make the journey from Babylon to Jerusalem with their swords by their sides and trowels in their hands. Despite great sorrow and travail, the temple was completed in the reign of Darius, successor to Cyrus. Darius chose Zerubbabel as Grand Master in charge of the construction of the second temple. Having passed difficult rites of initiation, Zerubbabel was given the title of Sovereign Prince of Jerusalem, and was entrusted with the sacred vessels Nebuchadnezzar had taken from Solomon's temple. Zerubbabel, together with King Darius, then founded a new order of temple builders known as Knights of the East. These knights were among the Masonic workmen who took part in the construction of the second temple. This new order of knights became a warrior fraternity. The Scottish Rite progressing through the 17th to 29th degrees of Freemasonry. The legend of Hiram Abiff continues. So far we have read about the Hiramic legend of past events. Let's now take a look at the way present-day Freemasonry builds upon the legend of Hiram Abiff. Below is a composite picture of the Masonic dedication within the life of the individual Mason of the Temple of the Great Architect of the Universe. Including many Scottish Rite rituals, of degrees 17 to 29, the following describes how the priest of Freemasonry makes his way from the outer court of the temple to the altar of incense before the veil. Let's now take a look. We shall create another composite picture of the manner by which the priest Freemasonry enters the Holy of Holies when considering the York Rite. The Freemason slowly makes his way into the outer court of the temple. He presents an image of spotless purity, for he is dressed in a chalk white gown linen with a matching turban, which has the words Holy unto the Lord upon its front. Around his waist is a scarlet sash with 12 golden stars upon it. Many trumpets begin to blow with anticipation. Kneeling before a group of linen-clad men, the Mason is anointed with oil. With quiet satisfaction, the priests of Freemasonry declare him to be a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek. The new priest of Freemasonry walks to the brazen altar. He solemnly pulls up his sleeves. Offering up his arms to assistants, the Masonic priest allows his arms to be cut with ceremonial knives. With an expression of solemn dignity, the priest watches impassively as his blood pours out, and runs down his arms before being collected in a bowl. Taking a bowl, the priest of Freemasonry sprinkles some of his own blood upon the altar, demonstrating that he himself is the blood sacrifice for sin. Other priests bind his wounds, and then lead him to the laver of water. Again, with great dignity, the priest washes his arms, hands, and face slowly, with great care to remove every unclean substance from his body. Only then is the priest of Freemasonry ready to enter the temple. With measured steps the priest leads a procession of priests of the Masonic order through the columns Boaz and Jachin, and under the keystone bearing the initials of Hiram Tyrian, widow's son, sent to King Solomon. The priest proceeds towards the altar of incense, which burns with fiery coals before the veil of the Holy of Holies. He notes with satisfaction the candlesticks and tables of shew bread, representative of the glory of the great architect of the universe, and the word of Yah-Bul'an. Arriving at the altar of incense, the priest of Freemasonry stops. Suddenly, with a dramatic gesture, he holds up a copy of the New Testament, before lighting it with the hot coals. The priests watch silently and intently while the flames consume the New Testament. When the flames disappear, the priest of Freemasonry declares, "It is finished." What blasphemy! The Scottish Rite 30th to 33rd degrees. The Hiramic legend ends with the House of Kadosh. Upon entering the 30th degree, the Freemason enters the holy house of the great architect of the universe, and rests from his labor. He can sing with truth the song, "There is no occasion for level or plumb line, for trowel or gavel, for compass or square, our works are completed, the ark safely seated, and we shall be greeted as workmen most rare." The gates of the New Jerusalem have opened to him, for he is now said to be perfect. He has become an eternal temple in which the great architect of the universe abides. The York Rite 1st to 10th degrees. Two sections ago we left the priest of Freemasonry in the holy place, before the altar of incense. He had burnt the New Testament, declaring it finished. Remembering that this account consists of rituals of the York Rite, let us see what happens next. To the growing excitement of the Masonic order, the priest takes his own blood from a bowl and places it upon the four horns of the altar of incense. He offers up prayers on behalf of the brethren, beginning with the reverent words, "Almighty and Sovereign Grand Architect of the Universe, Thou who ridest in the heavens by the name of Yah." When his prayer has finished, the priest turns, and solemnly nods his head. At this signal, seven priests of Freemasonry fan out throughout the holy place and extinguish the flames of the candlesticks. When the holy place is in darkness, the priest walks the few short steps to the veil, sprinkles his blood on the ground seven times, and declares loudly, "I am King of Heaven, and King of Earth and Hell." Throwing his rod, symbolic of the Aaronic priestly order, down before the veil, he declares, "I am, I am." He then rends the veil from top to bottom, picks his rod of priesthood up, and leads the Masonic priesthood arrogantly into the Holy of Holies. Before him lies the Ark of the Covenant with its mercy seat. Upon the seat are three skulls, while a skeleton lies before the Ark. Off to the side is an empty throne of gold. Stepping boldly up to the mercy seat, the priest of Freemasonry sprinkles his own blood upon it seven times. The priest then proceeds to open the Ark of the Covenant, declaring the name of Yah-Bul'an. He takes out of the Ark the rod of Aaron, and the tablets of the law, offering them to the other priests, who carefully place upon each item the mark of the square, compass and level. The contents are then put back in the Ark, before the skulls and an axe are replaced upon the mercy seat. As one, the priests of Freemasonry turn and watch as a replica of the temple capstone, bearing the name Tetragrammaton, is placed before the Ark. The ceremony now reaches its climax. Slowly, deliberately, yet with anticipation, the priest of Freemasonry approaches the golden throne. Before seating himself upon the throne, he is arrayed with a gown of royal blue and gold. A golden crown is then slowly lowered upon his head, signifying the attainment of godhood. As the crown settles upon his head, the priest of Freemasonry is suddenly transfigured with blazing light. The Holy of Holies and the remainder of the temple are also filled with the radiance of the light of the great architect of the universe. The glory of the great architect of the universe has filled his temple, and priest. Both have been found worthy, both have been sealed with the glory of the great architect of the universe. The temple has been completed. How do we get free? Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the God of Abraham, Isaac and Jacob, I acknowledge my need of you, and accept you as my Lord and Savior. I invite you now to be Lord of my life, Lord of my spirit and my relationship with you. Lord of my body and my behavior, Lord of my mind and my thinking, Lord of my tongue and the things I say, Lord of my emotions and my reactions, Lord of my will and all of my decisions, Lord of my sexuality, Lord of my time, my home, my family, my possessions and position, Lord of all my relationships with others. Thank you, Jesus, that your blood was shed that I might be free. Amen. The action required to take away Satan's rights is confess, repent, and renounce. What we must do, soul. Father God, Creator of heaven and earth, I come to you in the name of Jesus Christ your Son. I come as a sinner seeking forgiveness and cleansing from all sins committed against you, and others made in your image. I honor my earthly father and mother and all of my ancestors of flesh and blood and by adoption, but I utterly turn away from and renounce all their sins. I forgive all my ancestors for the effects of their sins on my children and me. I confess and renounce all of my own sins. I renounce Satan and all of his works in my family and me. I renounce and forsake all involvement in Freemasonry or any other lodge or craft by my ancestors and myself. I renounce witchcraft, the principal spirit behind Freemasonry, and I renounce Baphomet, the spirit of Antichrist and the curse of the Luciferian doctrine. I renounce the idolatry, blasphemy, secrecy, and deception of Masonry at every level. I specifically renounce the insecurity, the love of position and power, the love of money, covetousness, and greed, and the pride/arrogance that would have led my ancestors into Masonry. I renounce all the fears that held them in Masonry, especially the fear of death, fear of men, and fear of trusting, in the name of Jesus Christ. I renounce every position held in the lodge by any of my ancestors, including Tyler, Master, Worshipful Master, or any other. I renounce the calling of any man Master, for Jesus Christ is my only Master and Lord, and he forbids anyone else having that title. I renounce the entrapping of others into Masonry, and observing the helplessness of others during the rituals. I renounce the effects of Masonry passed on to me through any female ancestor who felt distrusted and rejected by her husband as he entered and attended any lodge and refused to tell her of his secret activities. Strongmen over Freemasonry, Jezebel, Antichrist, Death, and Hell, Freemasonry, Lucifer, Brumas, undergirding powers of lawlessness and Freemasonry. Renouncing and breaking the oaths. Soul. 1. I renounce Freemasonry with all its oaths, secrets, curses and rites. 2. I renounce the spirits of Freemasonry, Baphomet, lust, idolatry, and Brumas. 3. I renounce every ancestral spirit of Freemasonry, idolatry, Baphomet, Brumas, and lust in my family line. I renounce the curse of the Luciferian doctrine and commitment of the family to Lucifer. I renounce the Eye of Horus, all-seeing eye, at the top of the Freemasonry pyramid, and totally reject it as the deceptive representation of the Eye of Lucifer. 4. I renounce and cancel the Antichrist mark and seal from my family line in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I ask you to release the power of the shed blood of Jesus and apply the name of the Lord Jesus Christ as a seal on my forehead. Remove the square seal from the forehead. Break generational links and ungodly soul ties. Place the cross of Jesus Christ between candidate and generations back to the 10th generation. Destroy all curses, hereditary diseases. Break ungodly soul ties with relatives, partners, members, or officers of Freemasonry lodges and all other affiliated organizations such as Eastern Star, Orange Lodge and the Buffaloes, etc. Anoint middle of forehead with oil and cast out third eye of Horus. Close off the all-seeing eye on the lodge wall. Break the power of mind control and psychic power affecting the mind. Loose the mind to the truth of the Lord Jesus Christ. Do this for each degree. The Blue Lodge, 1st, 2nd and 3rd degrees, is the foundation of all Freemasonry. These prayers knock out the foundation entered apprentice, 1st degree, - shock of entrance if you attend one meeting, you joined. Soul. I renounce the new birth of Freemasonry, and all surrender of the will to an Antichrist spirit. I renounce the oath of having my throat cut from ear to ear, my tongue torn out by its roots, my body buried in the rough sands of the sea. I loose myself from all curses of allergies, asthma, glandular problems, death, and division in the family. I destroy the power of the first degree rituals. I remove the blindfold, hoodwink, from my eyes, and destroy the curses of migraines, fear, deception and spiritual or physical blindness. I cut the noose, cable tow, from around my neck and destroy the curses of breathing problems, choking, and control. I renounce first-degree initiation rites of violent blows to the throat and the resulting curses on the tongue and throat, and mouth, such as, speech disorders, cleft palate and silence. I destroy the curse of cutthroat off my life, and finances. I renounce the oath, of having my tongue torn out by the root and split from tip to root. I destroy all curses on my mouth, teeth, throat, vocal cords, sinuses and nose, and I claim the promise of Psalm 107:20. He sent his word and healed them and delivered them from destruction. I renounce the hand symbol across the throat and destruction of headship in ministry or leadership. I renounce the oath, you will not be able to speak in the day of judgment or make your own defense in time of accusation, and I destroy the curse of speechlessness, and having no voice. I destroy the power of the point of the dagger slash sword slash compass from my left breast and the curses and fear of heart problems connected to it. I renounce any blood covenant involving bloodletting. I renounce the words spoken of entering as a poor candidate seeking light and the poverty and spiritual blindness resulting from it. I remove and break the power of pauper's clothing with its poverty and humiliation. I renounce and destroy the power of the password dash Boaz and, the first degree handshake with its curse of pride and infirmity. I destroy the power of kissing the Masonic Bible and bowing at a Masonic altar thereby bowing to false gods, Baphomet. I remove and renounce the first degree white apron and destroy the curses of infirmities, especially in ankles, knees, and hips of women. I renounce all surrender and submission to, and destroy the power of, the great architect of the universe and the false gods and idolatry of Freemasonry in my life. I renounce and break the curse of Masonic false unity, and Masonic anointing with oil. I renounce the oath that binds the soul to serve the great architect of the universe and the God of the Masons for time and all eternity. All souls belong to the Lord God, the Creator, who is Jesus Christ, the Word, who made them all. All souls are His alone. Fellow craft degree, second degree, soul. I renounce the oath, of having my left breast torn open, my heart plucked out and fed to the birds of the air and the beasts of the field. I remove the hoodwink of the second degree and the cable toe from around my right arm slash shoulder with its curses of infirmity. I loose myself from fear of the dagger slash sword slash compass to my right breast. I remove the second degree pauper's clothing and its curse of poverty and humiliation. I destroy the power of the second degree hand grip and the sign and passwords dash Jachin and Shibboleth. I ask God for cleansing from touching slash kissing the Freemasonry Bible, and the second degree tools. I remove the two degree D degree apron and break the power of its curses. I destroy the power of the great architect of the universe second degree. I loose myself from the curse of the claw on my breast and heart. I destroy the power, and loose myself from every curse and fear of heart attack and breast cancer through this blood oath. I destroy the power and loose myself from the curse of death through heart and lung disease, chest, and circulatory problems. I destroy every curse of being shot or stabbed in the heart, and the curse of premature death from me and my descendants, and I loose those of my house into longevity and spiritual maturity. I renounce the badge of fellowcraft and all obsession with gaining knowledge. I renounce all blood covenants and slash or oaths of the second degree, including those that gave legal rights to the my family bloodline, and I break it now in Jesus Christ's name, I plead the blood of Jesus Christ to save. I renounce all emotional hardness, apathy, indifference, unbelief, deep-seated anger, and hardness towards God and spiritual things. I renounce the plumb line of Freemasonry, and destroy the curse of false Masonic righteousness and justice. Master Mason degree, third degree, soul. I renounce the oath, of having my body cut in two, my bowels torn out and burned to ashes, the ashes scattered to the four winds of the earth so there will be no more remembrance of such a vile wretch. I renounce all agreements with the spirit of death. I loose myself from stomach and reproductive problems, colitis, and always being overlooked. I renounce false humility, the false valley of the shadow of death, the false resurrection, the penal sign, the robe and hood, and all surrender of the will to Satan of the third degree. I renounce and break every effect off my life of two swords placed against the kidneys or waist. I remove the hoodwink and cable toe, noose, of the third degree and destroy curses of breathing problems and spiritual bondage. I remove the third degree pauper's clothing and its curses and the third degree apron and its curses. I destroy fear from compass points to both breasts. I renounce the blasphemy that Satan is the Most High. I announce Jesus Christ is Lord of all. I loose myself from all curses of occult injury, accidents, freak accidents, injury, and death, the fear of death, false martyrdom, and all rape and fear of rape, attack, or assault. I renounce and slash or repent of, and break all curses of sodomy that take place in the third degree. I renounce the demonic name slash passwords Mahabone and Machaben, which mean to be brought down or brought under. I break this curse off my life and generational line in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I renounce the three Freemasonry blows to the head and loose myself and my family from the curse of fear of ruffians, migraines, headaches, vision loss, blindness, head injury, and brain damage, aneurysms, stroke and blood hemorrhage. In the name of Jesus Christ I declare I shall not die from blows to the head. I destroy the power of the great architect of the universe over my life. I destroy the power of the mock death and resurrection of Hiram Abiff. I renounce the Masonic false Christ and Savior, Hiram Abiff, the false death and resurrection of Hiram Abiff, the false gospel and sacrificial blood of Hiram Abiff, the ritual death and murder of Hiram Abiff. I renounce all blood oaths taken by myself or my forefathers and, I cancel all covenants with death through the power of the blood of Jesus Christ. I destroy the power of the lost word for God Yabulon. I renounce seeking the Master's word. I declare that the word of God has not been lost, but totally revealed in the Lord Jesus Christ. I renounce the Freemason coffin and loose myself from the curse of death from off my body, marriage, children, employment, and relationships. I renounce the skull and crossbones on the Masonic coffin and any attraction to it, and loose myself from death by suicide, anorexia, accidents, risk-taking and death by hanging. I renounce adrenaline addiction causing flirtation with death, and destroy the curse of death and murder invoked through blood oaths, enacted ritual murder, and getting into a Masonic coffin. I destroy the curses of bowel cancer, stomach cancer, and death and accidents involving fire. I renounce Freemasonry's false light, angel of light, false sons of light, and, I declare I walk in the light of the Lord Jesus Christ according to 1 John 1:5-7. I loose myself from all counterfeit suffering, pain, and false martyrdom due to Freemasonry oaths. I cut off all fellowship with the suffering of a Freemason cross. I renounce the nine-headed serpent Hydra and its power and false light, the voice of Hydra and the curse and spirit of a medium, the divination of the Master Mason, the false King of Heaven, false Father, and false Son. I destroy the curse of God the Father being a stern judge and Masonic false duty. I destroy the power of any remaining Blue Lodge spirits, pride, secrecy, deception, brotherhood, loyalty, strongman over Blue Lodge. Once you have passed through the Blue Lodge and become a Master Mason, you have a choice of ascending the levels of Freemasonry by way of the Scottish, 32 levels, or York Rite, 10 levels, Scottish Rite Prayers Counselor Red. Note, every degree has a pattern, with each you must break the power of the ritual, lift off all clothing, headgear, footwear, break all oaths taken and contra curses, break the power of the handshake, pride, control, renounce false gods, break their power, break the power of the password and sign word, break power of words, mind control. Pride does not appear to be critical to go into detail in all higher degrees, although for a specific person there may be a specific degree that should be dealt with in detail. Lodge of Perfection, 4th to 1/4, degrees soul. I renounce and destroy the power of the Lodge of Perfection and all its rituals, clothing, oaths, passwords, sign words, and handshakes. I renounce the false god Jabulon, combination of Jehovah, Baal, Osiris, secret master, 4th degree. I renounce the secret word Adonai, represents a false god. I renounce the counterfeit candlestick of light, the Masonic serpent and worship of the phallus perfect master fifth degree. I renounce the secret word Acacia, Jehovah, Mahabon, represents a false god, intimate secretary, sixth degree. I renounce the secret word Jehovah, represents a false god, provost and judge, seventh degree. I renounce the court of justice of Freemasonry and destroy the power of the Masonic court case and losing a court case because of Masonic injustice. I renounce the oath, I will be dishonored and my life forfeited, with pain and torture. I renounce and destroy the curse of having my nose cut off. I renounce the secret word Hiram Tito Civiky. I renounce the curse of pain, torture, and dishonor over every function of my life, in my workplace, over my reputation, by my children, in all relationships. I destroy the curse of being fired, shunned, and disgracefully expelled. I destroy the curse of being exiled. I renounce the Masonic oath, to inflict vengeance on traitors, and destroy all spirits of vengeance over all relationships in my life. I claim the promise according to Jer 30:17, I will restore health unto you, and I will heal you of your wounds, says the Lord, because they called you an outcast, who no man seeks after. Intendant of the building, 8th degree. I renounce the oath, under the penalties of all my former obligations, besides that of having my body cut in two and my bowels torn out. I renounce the password Akarjaya. I renounce and destroy the false doctrine of perfectionism. Master of 9, 9th degree. I renounce the oath, I submit to perish by the vindictive weapon, dagger, which shall be given me as an honorable mark of this order. I destroy the Masonic curse of retaliation, murder, and death from my family generational line. I destroy the curse of being stabbed to death, physically, emotionally, mentally, or spiritually. Master elect of 15, 10th degree. I renounce the oath, having my body opened perpendicularly, and to be exposed for 8 hours in the open air, that the venomous flies may eat of my entrails, my head to be cut off and put on the highest pinnacle of the world, and I will always be ready to inflict the same punishment on those who shall disclose this degree. I destroy the curse of violence and death off my body, and the oath of taking Masonic vengeance upon those betraying Freemasonry's secrets. I renounce the secret word El Ignam. Sublime Knight of the 12, 11th degree. I renounce the oath, to have my body severed in two, my memory lost and looked upon as infamous and forsworn. So God and His holy evangelists be my help. I destroy the curse of having my body or hand cut in two and loss of memory and reputation. I renounce the secret word Stolken Adonai Grand Master Architect, 12th degree. I renounce the oath, to have my body severed in two, my memory lost and looked upon as infamous and forsworn. I further promise and consent that my name may be written in red letters and hung up in the chapter as a mark of infamy. I renounce and destroy the Masonic tools of the architect, and building pattern off my life, I declare my life will be built on the foundations of the Lord Jesus Christ. I renounce the secret word Rabbanim Royal Arch of Enoch or Master of the Ninth Arch of Solomon, 13th degree. I renounce the oath, consent to suffer all pains of my former obligations, my body to be exposed as food to the ferocity of the wild beasts. I am bound to the order forever, at the perils of my own life. I destroy the curse of my body being given to beasts as prey and my life being in peril of death. I renounce the password I am that I am, and Jehovah. Grand elect, perfect and sublime Mason or perfect Elu 1/4 degree. I renounce the oath, have my belly cut open, my bowels torn from thence and given to the hungry vultures. I renounce and destroy the seal of the great architect of the universe and the seal of Antichrist from off my life in Jesus Christ's holy name. I renounce and destroy all curses of death or disease off my stomach and bowels. I renounce the curse of inflicting vengeance upon those renouncing Freemasonry. I renounce perfectionism. I renounce the secret words Adonai, Bemake, Bimera, Jehovah, and Jodhivanhi, JHVH. Chapter of the Rose Croix, X is silent, soul. I renounce any oaths taken by my ancestors or myself and destroy the curses invoked through rituals, clothing, oaths, passwords, sign words, handshakes of the chapter Rose-Croix degrees, 1/5 to 18th degrees. Council of Princes of Jerusalem - 15-16 th degrees. I renounce the oaths taken by any of my ancestors or me and break the power of curses invoked in the Council of Princes of Jerusalem degrees of Freemasonry in Jesus Christ's holy name. Knight of the East or Sword, 1/5 degree. I renounce and take off the 1/5 degree apron. I renounce secret word RAPHODOM. I renounce the false warrior protecting the building of the Third Temple. I renounce the warrior fraternity and the false warrior mantle 1/5 degree. I renounce all alliance with the Prince of Persia and the law of control, domination, and Antichrist. I renounce the law of the Medes and Persians which usurps the place of the Lamb of God. I renounce being a knight sworn to wield the sword of retribution. Prince of Jerusalem, 16th degree. I renounce the oath, penalty of being stripped naked and having my heart pierced with a poniard. I renounce and take off the false warrior mantle and apron of 16th degree Freemasonry. I renounce the secret word Tevesidar. I renounce, break, and destroy all agreement with the Prince of Persia and the law of the Medes and Persians. I renounce and break the false warrior's sword of retribution. I renounce the oath of defending the Masonic Temple at all costs, including the lives of myself and my family. I destroy the curse of intimidation that comes with fear and violent threats, and the curse of defamation. I destroy the curse of lack of godly revelation and vision Knights of the East and West, 17th degree. I renounce the oath, penalty of not only being dishonored, but to consider my life as the immediate forfeiture, and that to be taken from me with all the torture and pains to be inflicted in manner as I have consented to in the preceding degrees. I renounce the password / sign word, the name and spirit of Abaddon, king of death and hell, and the lordship of Abaddon off my life, and every curse of death and infirmity. I renounce the ritual blood sacrifice of this degree, and shedding my own blood for the atonement of sin. I renounce being a Masonic blood sacrifice, I destroy the curse of Masonic false atonement, and destroy the curse of being sacrificed on a false altar of atonement. I come off the false altar of sacrifice, and declare the blood of the Lamb of God is my only atonement for sin. I ask God to release the blood of the Lamb of God over my bloodline. I renounce and destroy the curse of Masonic martyrdom, and the curse of untimely death with torture and pain. I renounce the breaking of the false seven seals, the explanation of the false seals, the mockery of Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, the curses of the seven seals. I loose my life and family into life in Christ Jesus, Rom 8:2, Knights of the Pelican and Eagle, and Sovereign Prince Rose-Croix of Haredim, 18th degree. I renounce the oath, penalty of being forever deprived of the true word, to be perpetually in darkness, my blood continually running from my body, to suffer without intermission the cruel remorse of soul, that the bitterest gall, mixed with vinegar, be my constant drink, the sharpest thorns for my pillow and the death of the cross may complete my punishment. Horrors which you have just seen are but a faint representation of those you shall suffer if you break through our laws, or infringe the obligation you have taken. I destroy the power of all these curses and destroy the curse of being emotionally and physically ravaged all my life. I destroy the curse of insomnia and having no rest, and the final punishment of a counterfeit cross. I renounce and destroy the power of the chapter Rose-Croix, and declare that I am totally coming out of the chamber of death of the Rose-Croix. I renounce the lie of perfection and self-righteousness with the 18th degree. I renounce the occult refining fire of the Rose-Croix. I renounce the secret words IGNE Natura Renovator Integra and its burning. I renounce the claim that Jesus Christ's death was a dire calamity. I renounce, remove, and destroy the veil of mourning. I renounce the spirit guide Raphael, the spirit guide of Freemasonry, and break its power, and declare I will only be guided by the Holy Spirit. I renounce and reject the Pelican witchcraft spirit and the occult influence of the Rosicrucians and the Kabbalah behind this degree, and the deliberate mockery of the doctrine of atonement, the rejection of the deity of Jesus Christ with the pelican shedding its own blood for its young. Symbol of 18:1H degree. I renounce the mockery of reading Isaiah 53 in this degree and taking on a savior mentality in helping others. I renounce and destroy the power of false communion of a biscuit, white wine, and salt with the absence of the broken body of Christ and any inability to accept the power of the cross, and any resulting curses from this. I renounce any evil use of, and break the power of the password/sign word, Emmanuel, INRI. Jesus of Nazareth, King of the Jews. I renounce the false new commandment to love one another given in this degree and any resulting codependency. I destroy its curse on my family and lose true godly love for each other. I renounce and destroy the spiritual yoke and curse of submission to the oaths of the 3/3 degree of Freemasonry. I renounce the 18th degree incense altar with all references to the veil being rent and counterfeit intercession. I renounce the mockery, and break the power of burning the New Testament and saying it is finished, and I loose myself from any imparted inability to receive revelation from the New Testament or read the Word of God, or inability to enter into the completed work of Jesus Christ when he said it is finished. *Note: This degree mocks the death of Jesus Christ on the cross. It attempts to knock out the foundation of the Christian faith. Council of Kadosh, 19-30. I renounce and destroy the curses of rituals, the penalties, clothing, oaths, password/sign words, and handshakes taken by my ancestors or myself involved in the Council of Kadosh, 19:30th degrees. I renounce and destroy the power of the false gods of these degrees. Grand Pontiff, 19th degree. I renounce the Grand Pontiff of the 19th degree. I renounce and destroy the curse of the Masonic thrice pus sent. I destroy the curse of the false Masonic throne and scepter. I renounce taking on the priesthood of Jesus Christ and the divination used to hide the priesthood of Satan. I renounce the holy anointing oil used, and the declaration that man becomes a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek. I renounce the false anointing of the 19th degree. I renounce astrology, the zodiac, and destroy the curses and powers of darkness with astrology and divination. I renounce the false fruit of the spirit that comes with Freemasonry. I renounce the false doctrine of the 19th degree, 144,000, and the doctrine of cults. I renounce the oath of total obedience which releases disobedience to the God of Israel. I renounce the 5 secret words/passwords of the 19th degree and their evil use. 1. Alleluia 2. Praise the Lord 3. Emmanuel 4. Godspeed you 5. Amen. Master Ad Vitam Venerable Grand Master, 20th degree, Grand Master of the Symbolic Lodge, Ankenberg. I renounce the secret words Jekson/Stolken. I renounce the false truth of Freemasonry, the light of Lucifer and occult knowledge. Patriarch Noachite or Prussian Knight Dash, 21st degree. I renounce the secret word Peleg Knight of the Royal Axe or Prince of Libanus, 22nd degree. I renounce the oath, penalty of exposure on the highest pinnacle of Mount Libanus, there miserably to perish in its perpetual snows. I renounce the secret words, Noah, Bezaleh Esadonias. I renounce and destroy the power of the Masonic axe to cut down God's people, and totally oppose the building of God's tabernacle. I renounce the Prince of Libanus or Lebanon. Chief of the Tabernacle, 23rd degree. I renounce the oath, no less a penalty than that of having the earth open under my feet and being swallowed up alive, like Korah, Dathan and Abiram. I renounce the password Uriel Jehovah. I renounce and take off the Masonic apron of the 23rd degree. I renounce the false mantle of priesthood. I renounce the false fruit of the spirit of Freemasonry, and the 7-branched candlestick of astrology. Prince of the Tabernacle, 24th degree. I renounce the oath, no less a penalty than to be consumed with fire from heaven, like Nadab and Abihu, and that my ashes should be flung into the air and blown to the four corners of the earth by the wind. And the penalty that I be stoned to death and my body left to rot above ground. I renounce the Masonic lamp of reason. The Masonic cloak of false liberty. The False Staff of Freemasonry. The Spirit of the Warlock. Knights of the Brazen Serpent, 25th degree. I renounce the oath, binding myself under no less a penalty than that of having my heart eaten by the most venomous of serpents and left thus to perish most miserably, from which may the Almighty Creator of the universe guide and defend me. Amen. I renounce the password of Moses Johannes. I destroy the curse of a broken heart and all emotional breakdown. I renounce the worship of the occultic brazen serpent, and loose myself from death by any venomous serpent, literal or spiritual. I renounce all false healing, and the false savior Osiris. I renounce and destroy the blockage of being healed completely. Scottish Trinitarian or Prince of Mercy, 26th degree. I renounce the oath, should I violate this, my obligation, I consent to be condemned, cast out and despised by the whole universe, may the Supreme Architect of the universe guide, guard, and protect me to fulfill the same. Amen. I renounce the password Gomel, Jehovah Jachin. I renounce the curse of condemnation and spite by the entire universe. I renounce and destroy the curse of a triple covenant with the great architect of the universe. I renounce and destroy the curse of the Egyptian Trinity. I renounce the curse of embracing a gospel of Jesus Christ mixed with the teachings of false religions. Knight Commander of the Temple, 27th degree. I renounce the oath. Penalty of receiving the severest wrath of God inflicted on me. I renounce the secret words of Jah, Solomon, Emmanuel and Inri, Jesus, Nazarenus, Rex, Judaeorum, Jesus of Nazareth, King of the Jews. I renounce the false warrior mantle of the Teutonic Knight, and the black two-headed eagle of false prophetic deliverance. Knight Commander of the Sun, or Prince Adept, 28th degree. I renounce the oath, may my brethren seize me and thrust my tongue through with a red-hot iron, to pluck out my eyes and deprive me of smelling or seeing, to cut off my hands and expose me in that condition in the field to be devoured by the voracious animals, and if none can be found, may the lightning of heaven execute on me the same vengeance. I renounce the secret word of Stibium. I renounce and destroy the power of these curses: eye injury, loss of vision, loss of smell, loss of hands or fingers, death by lightning or animal attack. I renounce the lie of being unable to rightly divide the word of God. I renounce and destroy the power of the seven angels, demonic beings, stationed in the lodge: Gabriel, Michael, Uriel, Raphael, Zarachiel, Tzaphiel, and Hamaliel, and cut all ties to them. Grand Scottish Knight of St. Andrew, 29th degree. I renounce the Masonic baptism into knighthood. I renounce the secret words Nechemaferlach. I renounce and destroy the power of the words they say Salah Eddin must die and the curse of destruction to my Christian walk. Grand Elect Knight Kadosh and Knight of the Black and White Eagle, 30th degree. I renounce the oath. With point of sword at heart, promise to do, under penalty of death. Ever Knight Kadosh shall be to me as if the ties of blood has united us. I henceforth devote and consign myself to disgrace and contempt, to the execration, means to call down a curse upon, and punishment of the Grand Elect Knights Kadosh, if I ever fail in this my solemn obligation. Also in this ritual forget not that the slightest indiscretion will cost me my life. One step more and you are bound to us forever and at the peril of my life. I destroy the power of the Council of Kadosh in my life. I renounce and destroy the power of the secret words Golgotha, Emmanuel, Stibum Alkabar, Farish Koh, and Melita. I renounce the knight's curse and death wish of Judas of having his head cut off and placed on top of a church spire. I cut every ungodly soul tie with the skull used in this degree. I renounce the ladder of reason, and its seven steps of science, astronomy, music, geometry, arithmetic, logic and rhetoric. I declare death to a spirit of humanism. I lose the spirit of revelation over myself and family. I renounce and destroy the curse of the death penalty. Consistory of Sublime Princes of the Royal Secret, 3 1st to 3 3rd degrees. I renounce and destroy the curses invoked by my ancestors or me through the rituals, clothing, oaths, passwords, sign words, and handshakes of the consistory of sublime princes of the royal secret degrees of Freemasonry, 3 1st-3 3rd degree. I renounce the false gods Ahura Mazda, Persian god of fire, Aum of the Hindus, Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva Hindu Trinity, Lucifer Artemis or Diana, Goddess Mother, Grand Inspector Inquisitor Commander, 3 1st degree. I renounce the oath, consigning myself to the contempt of my brethren and to their just and terrible anger, to be visited upon my unprotected head, if I should willfully or through indifference violate this my solemn oath and obligation. I renounce all the gods and goddesses of Egypt including Anubis, Ram's Head, Aten, Re, Ra, and Osiris, sun gods, and Isis, the moon goddess, Diana, or Artemis, mother goddess. I renounce the soul of Shears, the false symbol of immortality, the chamber of the dead, and the false teaching of reincarnation. I renounce and destroy the curse of the Masonic tribunal and trial, Masonic legalism and false repentance. Being judged by the ungodly sublime prince of the royal secret, 3 2nd degree. I renounce the oath, that you may be certain that we are all bound to you, by ties as strong as those that will bind you to us, kneel at our altar, lay your hands and sword upon the book of constitutions and repeat after me. I renounce the 3rd degree of Freemasonry and the deity of Ahura Mazda and the false Trinitarian deity Aum with its three parts Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva. I renounce the secret words Ful, Farish Kol, Ahura Mazda. I renounce and destroy the Masonic covenant with death, and the curse of being poisoned, especially my reputation and relationships. I renounce taking the oath that the wine will turn to poison and drinking from a human skull. I renounce and destroy the curse of sorcery and drug use over my life and descendants, the power of drug addiction, chemical overdoses, and death through drug overdose Grand Sovereign Inspector General, 3 3rd degree. I renounce the oath. And should I knowingly or willfully violate the same, may this wine I now drink, from a human skull, become a deadly poison to me, as the hemlock juice drank by Socrates. And may these cold arms forever encircle me, a skeleton's arms are wrapped around the candidate, penalties which I, of my own free will and accord impose upon myself, namely that of being disgraced among my fellow beings, to suffer the most cruel remorse of the soul. And may God heap upon my head the punishment in store for perjurers and all such as may violate their sacred obligations toward him. I renounce and destroy the power of Lucifer and the consistory over me. I renounce the secret words, Demole Hiram Abiff, Frederick of Prussia, Micha, Maka, Balaam, and Adonai. I renounce the death wish and death by poisoning. I renounce and remove the robes of witchcraft, and the declaration that Lucifer is God. I renounce and cancel the curse of the 33D degree news, cable to. I renounce the three infamous assassins of the Grand Master Law, Property, and Religion, and what they mean greed, witchcraft, and attempt to control and manipulate. I renounce the words a three-edged blade to pierce the eyeball, and destroy all curses to the eyes involving accidents, progressive or total blindness, cataracts, eye disease, eye pain and unnatural loss of sight linked in any way to this blood oath. I announce that Isaiah 32:3 is my portion, the eyes of them that see shall not be dim. And Jeremiah 30:17, I will heal thee of thy wounds. Shriners. I renounce the Shriner's oath, I do hereby, upon this Bible, and on the mysterious legend of the Quran, and its dedication to the Mohammedan faith, promise, swear and vow. In willful violation whereof may I incur the fearful penalty of having my eyeballs pierced to the center with a three-edged blade, my feet flayed and I be forced to walk the hot sands upon the sterile shores of the Red Sea until the flaming sun shall strike me with livid plague, and may Allah, the God of Arab, Muslim, and Mohammedan, the God of our fathers, support me to the entire fulfillment of the same, Amen, Amen, Amen. I renounce the oaths taken by my ancestors or me and the curses and penalties involved in the ancient Arabic order of the nobles of the mystic shrine. I renounce the curse of madness. I destroy all curses of afflictions to the feet in the name of Jesus Christ. I renounce the curse of piercing the eyeball with a three-edged blade. I renounce and destroy the power of the three third-degree Masonic ring, made up of three bands and often set with three diamonds. York Rite Mark Master fourth degree. I renounce the false cornerstone of Hiram Abiff, and declare that Jesus Christ is the chief cornerstone of my life. I renounce the keystone astrological mark. I renounce the curse of rejection from the Lord's temple. I renounce the false trinity of Freemasonry. I renounce and break the curse of the fourfold cable toe, total immobilization, and every tie to a Freemasonry lodge. I renounce the word Japa and rebellion to the voice of God. I renounce and break the power of these curses, loss of the fruit of my labor, and being underpaid as an employee. Lack of financial blessing and working long and hard for little financial reward. Every curse of poverty invoked through this degree's ceremonies past Master 5th degree. I renounce the oath, binding myself under no less penalty than to have my tongue split from the tip to the root. I renounce and destroy the power of all curses of the speech through the oath of the entered apprentice degree. I renounce and destroy the curse of ungodly takeover. I renounce the master abdication ceremony, premature promotion, and the curse of humiliation. Most excellent Master 6th degree. I renounce the oath. Penalty of having my breastbone open and vital organs removed and exposed to rot on the dunghill. I renounce and break every effect of the balancing ceremony and the curse of yielding to temptation. Holy Royal Arch 7th degree. I renounce the oath. Penalty of my brain being exposed to the scorching rays of the meridian sun. I renounce the lie of self-godhood and the triple crown of godhood, the blasphemy of equality with the Lord God Almighty, the false crown, robes, false open heaven, and false glory, the four veils and false holy of holies. I renounce and destroy the curse of the password I am, and break every effect of being knighted as captain of the hosts. I renounce and break every effect of the passwords Shem, Japheth, and Adoniran. I renounce and break the rod of divination, and all false miracles, signs, and wonders, and where they have affected me in any Christian meeting. I renounce being a false leader over the people of the Lord, and renounce and destroy false fathering and false sonship. I renounce salvation through good works and break the power of the triple tau mark from my forehead. I renounce and break the curse of the Masonic god Yabulon. I destroy all ties to the Baals of Syria, Babylon, and Egypt and declare over. I renounce the false office of prophet. I renounce the law of sin and death and loose myself into the law of the spirit of life, Romans 8:2. I renounce the Hindu gods Brahman, Krishna and Kali, and the resulting attraction to Hinduism, TM, yoga, and Eastern philosophy. I renounce the false love and unity of Freemasonry. I renounce and break every effect of the secret passwords Mi Ruhama and Stibium Makabar. I renounce this oath, having my right ear smote off that I may forever be unable to hear the word, and my right hand struck off as the penalty of an impostor. I renounce the inability to hear God's word, and break the power of spiritual deafness or loss of fingers or hands because of this oath. I renounce this oath, having my bowels torn asunder, and that the earth may open and swallow me up as it did Korah, Dathan, and Abiram for their rebellion. I renounce and destroy the power of the hand grip and password Rabboni, and the following of a false master or leader. I renounce and break every effect of the passwords of this degree Haggai, Joshua, and Zerubbabel. I renounce this oath, having the crown of my head struck off, and my brains taken out and burned to ashes. I renounce this oath, the skull struck off and the brain exposed to the scorching rays of the noonday Sunday. I renounce the curse of confusion, memory problems, decapitation, brain cancer, and chemotherapy for its super excellent Master 10th degree. I renounce this oath, penalty of having my thumbs cut off, my eyes put out, my body bound in fetters of brass and being taken captive to a strange land. I renounce and destroy the curse from role-playing King Zedekiah, of an immobilized will of having my thumbs cut off, of physical blindness from eyes being put out. I destroy the curse of the bronze shackles of witchcraft. Orders of Knighthood, Knights Order of the Red Cross 11th degree. I renounce the oath, penalty, of having my house torn down, the timbers therefore, set up, and I being hanged thereon. I renounce the passwords Truth, Judah, and Benjamin, and taking on the character of the lion and the wolf. I renounce the spirit of the roaring lion, the devil himself, 1 Peter 5:8, I declare that Jesus Christ is the lion of the tribe of Judah, Revelation 5:5, Knights of Malta 12th degree. I renounce and break the oath, if I violate my obligation, I consent to have my head cut off, and stuck on the highest pinnacle in the eastern part of the world, as a monument to my villainy. I renounce and break every effect of the oath, the sins of the person whose skull this once was be heaped upon my head in addition to my own, and may he appear in judgment against me, both here and hereafter, should I violate or transgress in masonry, or orders of this knighthood. I renounce drinking wine from a human skull, and the oath of taking on the sins of another. I renounce the false symbol of salvation, the white robe and black cross. I renounce the secret word Marshal al-Hashbaz Knights Templar 13th degree. I renounce and break every effect of any of my forebears wearing the Knights Templar belt, breastplate, spurs, helmet and black apron with its emblems, and taking the sword of the York Rite. I renounce and spiritually remove this false armor from myself and my family. And I put on the full armor of Ephesians 6:11. I renounce the spirit of death of the Knights Templar. I renounce the false warrior spirit of this order. I renounce and destroy the curse of the emblems and insignia of the black apron with a serpent entwined about a cross, skull, and crossbones, and the curse of the sword, battle axe, trumpet and shield. I renounce the secret password of Kebraith. I destroy the curse of the tomb and renounce and break every effect of the skull and crossbones on the Bible in the black room. I renounce the false alliance between the Bible and the black coffin, death. I renounce the Masonic cock crow, the spirit of Judas Iscariot, and destroy the curse of betrayal. I renounce the cup of death and the cup of desolation. Ezekiel 23:33. I renounce and break every effect of drinking wine from a skull called Old Simon in memory of Simon of Cyrene, and drinking to Simon, Solomon, Hiram of Tyre and Hiram Abiff. I loose myself into the cup of blessing and salvation. 1 Corinthians 10:16, Psalms 116:13. I renounce and destroy the power of the passwords Golgotha and my Lord. I renounce Masonic covenant with death, and I claim the promise of Jesus Christ, I have come that they may have life. I renounce and take off the warrior mantle of death of the Knights Templar. I renounce and release the false sword of the York Rite and using the sword as an inverted cross. I throw the Masonic sword into the fire of God, with action. I declare I am taking hold of the word of God, which is sharper than any two-edged sword. Hebrews 4:12. I renounce and destroy the curse of violence and rage against myself and others, of dying a violent death, and all fascination with warfare. I renounce the false warrior mantle of Freemasonry over my calling in God, and my obedience to the word of the living God, over every anointing and every gift of the Holy Spirit. I renounce and break every effect of my ancestors' involvement in all the side degrees of the York Rite, select master, degree of Ark and Dove, Knights of Constantinople, secret monitor or trading degree, heroine of Jericho, Knights of Three Kings, Knight of the Christian Mark and Guards of the Conclave, Knights of the Holy Sepulchre, the Holy and Thrice Illustrious Order of the Cross, called a Council, 11 Ineffable Degrees, Perfect Master, Intimate Secretary, Provost and Judge, Intendant of the Building, or Master in Israel, Elected Knights of 9, Elected Grand Master, Sublime Knights Elected, Grand Master Architect, Knight of the Ninth Arch, Grand Elect, Perfect and Sublime Mason. I renounce the oath of the penalty, of having my head struck off and placed on the highest spine of Christendom. Physical diseases. I renounce all curses of cancer on my ancestral line and myself because of oaths pronounced over the body through Freemasonry. I take authority over, and command every rebellious cell within my body to come into perfect order, and line up with the original plan and design of the Ancient of Days. I renounce and break all curses of fear of cancer, and death through cancer. I renounce and break every curse over the body organs, such as heart, lungs, stomach, intestines, gallbladder, liver, bladder, and womb. I renounce all curses of heart attack, open heart surgery, stroke, heart disease, and resulting premature death. I renounce and break all curses of the blood resulting from Freemasonry blood oaths, such as chronic fatigue syndrome, anemia, high/low blood pressure, thrombosis, hemorrhaging, rheumatoid arthritis, diabetes, hypo or hyperglycemia, blood poisoning, hepatitis, and AIDS or HIV extreme fatigue and infirmities. I renounce and break every curse of infirmity and continual illness that affects my ancestral line and myself because of Freemasonry ceremonies and blood oaths. I loose my ancestral line, myself, and my descendants from all infirmity, allergies, and continual illness in the name of Jesus Christ. I destroy the stronghold of death and hell over my body to destroy it. I renounce and break the curse of occult spiritual blows to the head resulting in migraine or death, and break the curse of sudden mysterious fevers. I renounce and break the curse of rejection resulting from being called rubbish in the temple and the resulting curse of being shunned, or put out of the church fellowship. I break every curse of being unfruitful in the church or for the kingdom of God. Mental illness. I renounce and break all curses of mental illness coming down my ancestral line due to involvement in Freemasonry. I renounce and break the curse of having a double soul, double mind, ad, or being bipolar. I break the power of spiritual and mental confusion in the name of Jesus Christ. I renounce and break all curses that disable me from comprehending and articulating what I feel. I break all curses on my verbal faculties, and the ability to hear spiritually and physically. I renounce and break the curse of having two fathers or masters and the resulting confusion in identity. In the name of Jesus Christ, I call my body, soul and spirit into perfect alignment, according to God's perfect plan and will. I renounce and break the curse of paranoid schizophrenia and fear from my ancestral line and myself. I renounce and break the power of Freemasonry witchcraft oaths and curses resulting in depression, melancholy, oppression, and being in a psychotic state. I break all ungodly ties or bonds to anyone in my family line with the same problems. I renounce and break the power of the curses of the Freemasonry ceremony involving Nebuchadnezzar. I renounce and break the power of all Freemasonry witchcraft oaths resulting in insanity, senility, or dementia, Alzheimer's disease, disorientation, confusion, loss of memory, breakdown of any kind, mental, emotional, spiritual, nervous or physical. I break the curse of being committed into a psychiatric hospital or asylum. I renounce and break the curse of obsessive compulsive, repetitive behavior. I break the curse of all religious, spiritual, doctrinal obsessions. I renounce and break the curses of suicide, death wishes, and mental instability. I renounce and break all curses of insecurity and codependency due to abandonment by the Father because of Freemasonry, nervous disorders and fear. I renounce and break all the curses on the nervous system coming down my family line due to involvement in Freemasonry. I renounce the Shriner's ceremonial ritual and oath of standing on a board in bare feet and having electric shocks transmitted through the body. I renounce all curses of shock to the nervous system, all attraction to electroshock treatment, and death from electric shock. I renounce and break the curse of all shock, fear, trauma, and grief stored in the nervous system through accident, sudden shock, sudden loss, and death or through inheritance. I declare in the name of Jesus Christ, that I am loosed from this fear and shock and it is broken from my generational lines. I declare that continual shocks are broken from my family and me. I loose myself from fear of accidents, rape, any kind of loss, and blows to the head. I renounce and break the power of Freemasonry occult curses to afflict my ancestral line and myself with diseases or violence affecting the nerves such as multiple sclerosis, epilepsy, spinal cancer, Parkinson's disease, sexual abuse, rape, sudden death, or betrayal by friends or marriage partner. I break the power of the Masonic curse of death from the spinal cord, nervous system, and silver cord in the name of Jesus Christ. I renounce and break every curse of inflammation of the nerves and the nerves being on edge. I declare that my body is the temple of the Holy Spirit and all ties to the Masonic temple is cut in the name of Jesus Christ, and I am loosed from every known or unknown disorder and disease resulting from a Freemasonry curse. Every negative thing lodged in my nervous system is now dislodged and I now plead the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ over every access point that is now closed. Autism and learning difficulties. I renounce and break the curses of autism on my ancestral line and myself due to involvement in Freemasonry. I renounce the Antichrist brotherhood of Freemasonry and destroy the curse of abandonment it produces in marriage and with children due to the father being at the lodge. I forgive the fathers in my family line for abandoning their wives and family for the lodge, and the resulting insecurity, rejection, and rebellion. I loose myself from all curses of insecurity, rejection, rebellion. I renounce and break the curse of atheism in the fathers of my ancestral line, resulting in an inability to enter into true intimacy with Father God. I break all curses of hatred and rejection towards the Father. I renounce and break the curse of the spirit of Antichrist and Jezebel due to the loss of the Father, and the resulting autism in all its forms. I repent, renounce, and break the curse of violence from the mothers in my family line and repent of abuse of children. I break the curse of all words of rejection and judgment spoken over children. I break all curses of blows to the head and the resulting brain damage, intellectual retardation, learning and comprehension difficulties, slowness of speech and action, spastic thought patterns, speech patterns, and motor coordination difficulties. I renounce and break the curses of insanity, autism, frustration, anger, self-hatred, violence, self-injury, head-banging and all insane behaviors connected to the Freemasonry blood oaths of murder and mutilation. I renounce all fear of the occult from the Freemasonry blood oaths. I renounce and break the curse of shutting down or off from reality. I break every curse of withdrawal, escapism, fantasy, and denial of pain. I renounce all emotional withdrawal and escapism such as staying in bed, sleep, sex, television, computer, job, drugs, and alcohol. I renounce and break the curse of the oath I will withdraw myself from anyone that does not walk after the traditions of Freemasonry, and I destroy every legal right of withdrawal off my life and my family line. I renounce all rebellion against reality and repent of stubbornness in Jesus Christ's name. I break all curses affecting my family line relating to their gifting, creativity, learning abilities and anointings. I break all curses of rebellion towards authority, mistrust, and rejection of people and resulting obsessions with animals. I break all curses of animal behavior, of being treated like an animal and being subjected to physical, verbal, or sexual abuse. I break the curse of the Freemasonry tools from my family line and myself and the resulting problem with mathematics. I loose my family line and myself into God's original plan and purpose for our lives in the name of Jesus Christ. Interconnected religions and orders, men organizations, youth organizations, girls, daughters of job, rainbow girls, girl guides, girl scouts in US, brownies, sparks, daughters of the Eastern Star, ladies oriental shrine, boys order of Demoli, order of the builders, cubs, boy scouts, the allied degrees, the Red Cross of Constantine, the Order of the Secret Monitor, Masonic Royal Order of Scotland, Grand Orient Lodges, the Royal Order of Jesters, the Manchester Unity, Order of the Eastern Star. I repent, renounce, and break the curse for all oaths taken, curses and ritual enacted, and regalia worn by my ancestors involved with the Eastern Star. In the name of Jesus Christ, I smash and destroy the power of the pentagram, symbol of the Eastern Star, from my family line and myself. I declare that the blood of Jesus Christ covers us. I'll sever every cord that binds my family or myself to Freemasonry through the Eastern Star and renounce and break the curse of mutual obligation. I renounce this oath, I bind myself to the most solemn secrecy respecting the work of the order and to that performance, of its goals, the obligation of our order, voluntarily assumed, is perpetual, from the force of which there is no release. I declare that my family is released through the power of the blood of Jesus Christ. I repent on behalf of the women in my ancestral lines that knelt before the altar of the Eastern Star and knowingly, or in ignorance gave themselves to the gods of Freemasonry. I renounce and break the power of the curse of false light, purity, and joy. I declare that the joy of the Lord is my strength and the fruit of the Holy Spirit is mine. I renounce and break all the oaths and rituals of Freemasonry. The Orange Lodge. I repent, renounce, and break the curse for all oaths taken, curses and ritual enacted, and regalia worn by my ancestors involved in the Orange Lodge. I renounce and break every curse and bondage from their involvement with the noble ancient and Christian Order of Royal Black Knights, Royal Arch Purple Order and the Royal Black Institution and cut all ties to Freemasonry. I renounce and break all soul ties, idolatry, and association with the founders James Wilson and James Sloan, also with Sir Robert Peel and King William of Orange and Osiris. I renounce and break the curse of the five-pointed star and the Eye of Horus. I renounce the oath never to prosecute an Orange brother. I repent, renounce, and break the curse of religious bigotry and indoctrination from my ancestral line. I renounce and break the curse of death and destruction and the ungodly militancy of the Orange Lodge. I renounce and break the curses of all Orange, Purple and Black degrees up to and including the Red Cross. I renounce and break every tie to the goat of the Orange Lodge. I renounce and break all oaths made while sitting on a goat. I renounce the ceremony of riding the goat and break the curse of violence and fear. I repent for every ancestor involved in swearing allegiance to Lucifer by kissing the goat's anus. I break all the resulting curses and ask you, Father God, to cleanse me in the name of Jesus Christ. I renounce and break the curses of the 2½ sign and the following passwords: entrance password Shibboleth, central password the Ark of God, goat backwards, great and grand password the Great Jehovah be our guide, other passwords Migdal, Reuben, Gad, Half, Tribe, Manasseh, Red Walls, Gideon, and Onde Gi. I renounce and break the power of all handshakes, sign words, and declare there will be no more codes, signs or passwords over my life. Independent Order of Rechabits, IOOR. I repent, renounce, and break the curse for all oaths taken, curses and ritual enacted, and regalia worn by my ancestors involved in the Independent Order of the Rechabits. Father, in Jesus Christ's name, I ask you to erase with the blood of Jesus the names of my ancestors and myself from all certificates and lists of the I.OO.R. I renounce and break all curses of the IOOR coat of arms, its symbols and meanings for the Eye of Horus, the serpent, the sun, moon, and stars, rainbow, the wheat sheaf, the beehive and the twisted cord. I break all bondage to divination and Jezebel through this order. I repent, renounce, and break the curses of having an independent spirit because of this order and living as a vagabond or nomad. I renounce the IOOR motto peace and plenty, the rewards of temperance. I renounce and break the curse of murder and decapitation and the loss of headship slash leadership as a result. I cut all soul ties to the priesthood of this order, and to the Queen of Heaven, Jezebel, and declare that there will be no more destruction in the name of Jesus Christ. The Buffalo Lodge, RAOB, Royal Antediluvian Order of Buffaloes. I repent, renounce, and break the curse for all oaths taken, curses and rituals enacted, and regalia worn by my ancestors involved with the Buffalo Lodge. I renounce the idolatry of the bull, and break the curse to afflict my life with suffering. I renounce and break the curses from participating in the ritual of having the head symbolically shaved and being humiliated and mocked publicly. I renounce and break the power of all curses to the head and mind such as scalp diseases, loss of hair, anxiety, worry, and insanity. I declare that I have not been given a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. 2 Tim 1:7. I renounce and break the curse of a kangaroo court. I renounce and break all curses of being burned or burned to death sacrificially or accidentally. I renounce this oath, never to divulge the secrets, signs, tokens, or passwords, which may be given me by the lodge. I renounce all curses of secrecy and silence, especially with women. I renounce and take off the buffalo blindfold. I renounce and break the curse of misogyny, hatred of women, from my ancestral line. I renounce and break all buffalo curses of lust, adultery, marital breakdown, violence and arguments, polygamy, premature death of spouse, death of relationships and expecting to be betrayed by women/men. I renounce and break the curse of murder by blows to the head and all threats of violence. I renounce and break all curses from my ancestral line and myself of bull-like behavior, lying in the bed of the buffalo and the oath to gore and toss the victim. I renounce all curses of behaving or being treated like an animal and the curse of bestiality and confusion. I renounce and break all curses of the buffalo altar and horns, of being subjected to the buffalo roar, anger, violence, and rage. I renounce and break the power of idolatry of the Antichrist horns, and the curse of spiritual abuse and bleeding caused by these horns. I repent, renounce, and break every curse of alcoholism and addictions that came with the spirit of great John Barleycorn. I renounce the lie that Noah sent out a buffalo bird that did not return with an olive branch, and I break the curse of conflict it brings. I renounce and break the curse of the passwords Gideon and Red Walls. I renounce all worship of Baphomet and break the power of all curses of lust and perversion from my family lines. I break the curse of all sexual strongholds of lust, sodomy, homosexuality, and bestiality and, I ask you Father, in the name of Jesus to cleanse my family lines with the blood of the Lamb. Guides and Scouts. I repent, renounce and break all curses from my ancestral line and myself for being involved in the Girl Guides, Boy Scouts, and all other affiliated movements and orders that originated with Lord or Lady Baden-Powell. I repent for my ancestors and myself for all involvement and I now break every ungodly tie to the movement. I break every soul tie to Lord or Lady Baden-Powell and Freemasonry. I break every allegiance to Akela. I break every ungodly soul tie to Akela, leaders, or members of the movement, pack, or association, etc. I repent of and break the curse of the Baphomet witchcraft salute, three-finger hand salute given facing east. I ask you Father God to cleanse me now in Jesus Christ's holy name. The New Age. I repent, renounce, and break every curse on behalf of my ancestors and myself for involvement in the New Age. I repent and renounce seeking after false spiritual power and the belief in New Age systems, practices, therapies, and philosophies. I cut all soul and spirit ties to these practices, practitioners, gurus, false prophets in the name of Jesus Christ. I bind every unclean spirit that has attached to me from association with the New Age and loose myself from it in the name of Jesus Christ. I repent of and renounce all New Age ideals, lifestyles, and seduction. I renounce the New World Order and the One World Church of the New Age. I repent, renounce, and break every curse of being in an altered state of consciousness. Father God, I ask you in the name of Jesus Christ, to cleanse me and close every open psychic door or portal. Kabbalism. I repent, renounce, and break all curses associated with ancestral involvement with Kabbalism. I renounce any ungodly spiritual tie to Kabbalism. I renounce any subtle ungodly drawing towards Kabbalism and demonic bonding to religious traditions and Kabbalism doctrines mixed with my prayers for Israel. Mormonism. I repent, renounce, and break all curses resulting from ancestral involvement in Mormonism, and I renounce the deception and error behind it. I renounce all oaths made and curses invoked for revealing the temple secrets. I sever every family tie to Joseph Smith, Brigham Young and all false prophets and priests associated with the Mormon Church. I renounce the idolatry of man. I repent for myself and anyone in my family line having removed their shoes to enter a Mormon church/temple. I ask you Father to wash me and I will be clean. I renounce the angel Moroni, the lie of Mormon godhood and the doctrine of Mormonism. I renounce the doctrine of eternal progression and break its curse off my mind and spirit. I renounce and break every Mormon spirit of control, domination, manipulation, divination, lust, passivity, seduction, and fornication in the name of Jesus Christ. I renounce the Mormon lies that God is made of flesh and bone and that Jesus Christ is Satan's older brother. I renounce Mormon false atonement and the lie that salvation is only found through the Mormon Church. I repent, renounce, and break every curse from every ceremony, ritual, oath and baptism taken by my ancestors or others on my behalf. I renounce the Mormon temple baptism ceremonies with the bronze bulls. I renounce all baptisms for the dead in my family line. Father, I ask you to remove my family names from membership lists, genealogy lists of the Church of the Latter-day Saints in Jesus Christ's holy name. I renounce and break the power of the ceremony of eternal marriage and the curse of every seal, for eternity, every endowment, eternal ordinance, and anointing of the Mormon Church. I renounce and break the curses of all ceremonial regalia of the Mormon Church, the white suit, white robes, linen aprons, headwear, sashes, special protective underwear with its Masonic symbols. I repent and renounce putting the hand through a veil and being pulled into a heavenly realm. I close all open doors and portals in my life in the name of Jesus Christ. I renounce and break the curse of the new name given to my ancestors. I renounce and break the curses of every handshake, password, sign word, grip, and symbol used in Mormon temple ceremonies. I renounce and break the curse of the sure sign of the nail and break the curse of blood covenant. I renounce and break the curse of becoming a priest after the order of the false Aaronic and Melchizedek priesthood. I break every ungodly soul tie with the Mormon priesthood. I renounce and break the curse of the Mormon Bible, the Book of Mormon, the sacred writings, the pearl of great price, and the hidden gold plates from which the Book of Mormon was transcribed. Lies of Freemasonry Counselor, reads the Bible is not to be literally obeyed as it is merely symbolic of God's will. The Bible is part of God's revelation and other books of faith are equally acceptable. There is no need to repent, because man is not sinful. Whatever a person believes is the truth. Man's redemption comes by his own good deeds and righteousness. We can be a God. Every degree of Freemasonry reveals more light and light is darkness visible. A Freemason is a free man. Soul. I renounce and break the power of these lies and any resulting curse of deception from my life, my descendants, and my ancestral lines. I renounce and break the curse of idolatry of self, and the false gospel of salvation through good works. I break the stronghold of deception and every tie with Jezebel and Antichrist. Freemasonry's blasphemy counselor, reads Jesus is dead and there is no resurrection. God is not a triune God. The Lord's light will be extinguished in your life. Jesus was just a great reformer. Jesus is the evil influence in the world. There is no power in the communion cup for healing, deliverance and true fellowship with the Lord Jesus Christ. There is no power in the cross of Jesus Christ. Masonic communion is based on the doctrine of transubstantiation and they believe you eat the literal flesh of Moses, Confucius, Plato, Socrates, and Jesus of Nazareth. When you take Masonic communion, their teaching is that you do not need a living Christ. The name of God is Yabulon. Adonai, Jehovah, and Emmanuel are passwords. Jesus Christ is not God, the great architect of the universe, J-O-T-U, is the one true God of Freemasonry. Lucifer is the master and lord in your family line. Eternal life is gained by a password and living a perfect, pure, and blameless life, therefore you don't need to live a Christian life, because you have the password. The worshipful Grand Master in Freemasonry replaces the Holy Spirit. The gods of Freemasonry are, the Sun God, Moon God, Egyptian gods, Persian gods, the Hindu gods, also Aum with three parts, Brahma, Creator, Vishnu, Preserver, and Shiva, Destroyer, and Yabulon, Jehovah, Baal, Osiris. Soul. I renounce and destroy the power behind these blasphemies from my ancestral line and from myself. I ask you, Father, to cleanse my lips with fire from God's altar in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Apostles' Creed, I believe in God the Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead and buried, he descended into hell, the third day he rose again from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and sits on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the holy body of believers, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Freemasonry's false priesthood. I renounce the false priesthood of Freemasonry and sever every tie to it. I renounce Freemasonry's veil and secret place as a place of bondage, death, and destruction to relationship with Jesus Christ. The lodge or temple. I renounce the lodge as holy ground, and destroy all curses of standing on counterfeit holy ground and removing my shoes as a sign of humility. I declare I am released from the lodge in the name of Jesus Christ, and I break every tie with the false tabernacle or temple of Satan. The counterfeit Bible. I repent, renounce, and break every curse on my ancestral line and my life from involvement with the Freemasonry volume of the sacred law. I declare I receive the Holy Bible as the inspired word of God that it is, and I renounce any inability to receive pure undefiled doctrine because of the volume of the sacred law. I renounce and break every curse of the volume of the sacred law. I break and destroy the curse that my family and I will have the plagues recorded in Revelation because of blood oaths taken. I renounce and break the curses of the Freemason Bible with its coded messages that would keep God's word a mystery, and any resulting difficulty in receiving revelations from the Word of God. I renounce the curse of unbelief, doubt and skepticism, denying the power of the Word of God and the miraculous. I declare I will be able to read the Word of God with full acceptance and revelation of God's supernatural power, and miracle-working power of the blood of Jesus Christ. I declare that I will know Jesus in His power and resurrection. I renounce kissing the Freemasonry Bible, the VSL, volume of the sacred law, and all the betrayal represented by this action. I renounce all hatred and rejection of the Word of God, difficulty in reading or studying the Word, and resistance to the preached and quickened Word of God. I repent, and renounce resistance and mockery towards the Church, where God's Word is proclaimed. I renounce resistance to, and mockery of God's pastors, prophets, and servants. I destroy the power of the words, "For the Western soul, it is well for a man to be born in church, but terrible to die in one. A young man should be censured if he does not attend church, but an elderly man is to be equally censured if he does." Deception and seduction. I renounce and break the curses of Freemasonry deception, seduction, and lies. I break the curses of being lied against, of false witness, false verdict, treason, and perjury because of Masonic favoritism. I break every curse of being a scapegoat. I renounce this oath, I will aid and assist a companion Freemason when engaged in any difficulty, and espouse his cause so far as to extricate him from the same, whether it be right or wrong. I renounce and break every curse of spiritual blindness and deception in my ancestral line and my life from Freemasonry strongholds. Lord Jesus, I ask you to anoint my eyes with the eye salve of God that I might see. Freemasonry regalia. I renounce the Freemasonry regalia and the bondage associated with it. I remove them piece by piece spiritually, with action and declaration. Symbols. I renounce all these symbols and what they mean. I renounce and break the curse of checkmate off my life. I declare I am off the Masonic occult chessboard. I declare I will move ahead into God's plan and purpose for my life, in ministry, finances, business, and relationships. I declare I will not compromise my Christian values. I will stand for righteousness and against evil. I declare I am maturing in God without a mixture of Freemasonry pride, striving and false worship. I declare my family and I are under the shed blood and blessings of Jesus Christ and not the pelican curse, the skull, false crosses, death and spilled blood of Freemasonry. Freemasonry tools. With this hammer of God, His Word, and in the Spirit, I smash and destroy. I renounce these Freemasonry tools and destroy the curse of continual pain, occult, physical, spiritual and emotional pain and suffering over my home, marriage, job, or church. I renounce the Freemasonry saying meeting on the level and parting on the square over my church life, this denotes equality of all religions. I renounce the false gospel of salvation by good works and human efforts, ceremonial clothing and devices. I renounce and destroy the power of the curses of the ceremonial clothes, devices, and actions used in initiation rituals and progression through the levels of Freemasonry. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I declare I am removing the blindfold, hoodwink, and renounce being hoodwinked. I destroy the curse of fear of the dark or light and spiritual or physical blindness. I cut the Masonic cable toe, and renounce any ungodly covenant with the noose of Freemasonry and resulting breathing problems, choking, and neck afflictions. I destroy the power of the curses and spirits of allergic reactions, asthma, emphysema, hay fever, wheezing, and all other breathing problems in Jesus Christ's name. I renounce manipulation by witchcraft, ungodly religions, and cults. I cut the cable toe and all legal rights of being wrongly led and manipulated. I renounce and remove the Masonic pajamas and the vulnerability and humiliation represented. I destroy the compass, and its curse to immobilize my spiritual life. I declare I shall move ahead in God and not be stopped or stabbed by any occult curse. I remove the right heel slipshod, and renounce and break the curse of being unable to stand on holy ground or enter into worship in church. I remove, renounce, and break the curse of the white tunic, white mantle, armor and helmet of the Knights Templar, and the false anointing and armor they represent. I remove, renounce, and break the curses of the black robe and hood of witchcraft and renounce bowing down to the will of Satan. I remove, renounce, and destroy the power of the veil of mourning of Freemasonry. Passwords and codes. I renounce and break the curse and spiritual power of each password, sign, and code of Freemasonry over my life. I declare in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ there will be no passwords, signs, or codes over my life. Marriage communication and relationships. I renounce and break all curses off my life and my descendants' lives because of Freemasonry oaths taken by my ancestors. I repent, renounce, and break the curses of the occult covenant of Freemasonry. I break the curses of marriage breakdown, division in the family, continual arguments, violent arguments, continual pain and grief, separation, divorce, and emotional divorce resulting from the covenant ring of Freemasonry. I renounce, remove, and break the curse of the Freemasonry ring and throw it into God's fire. Take the Freemasonry covenant ring off the right fourth ring finger. I destroy the power of broken covenant over my marriage and my descendants' marriages. I destroy the curse of the power of hell coming against a godly marriage. I renounce the oath, binding myself to live a life hidden and secret even from my own wife. I renounce and break the curse of Freemasonry fraternity with its secrecy, mystery, and vow of silence. I renounce rebellion towards marriage and true covenant off my family line and myself because of the Freemason ring. I renounce and destroy the curse of singleness, or independent behavior and thinking in marriage. I renounce and break the curse that women and children are profane. I renounce and break the curse of separation and division of the family unit, extended family unit, and all breakdowns of relationships. I loose my ancestral line from an Antichrist spirit, and break all curses of stubbornness, pride, blame-shifting, angry and rageful arguments between spouses and hard-heartedness in the men. I announce to the enemy children are God's blessing, blessed is the man with a full quiver. PS 127:3-5, he who finds a wife finds a good thing and obtains God's favor. Proverbs 18:22, with God there is neither Jew/Greek, slave/free man, male/female. Galatians 13:26-29, violence and destruction. I repent and renounce and break the Freemasonry curses from my ancestral line and from myself, of violence and destruction due to blood oaths taken and rituals enacted. I break these curses off my body, family, marriage, work, and relationships. I repent and renounce all violence, cruelty, and verbal abuse. I ask you, Father God, to forgive my ancestors and myself for this in Jesus Christ's holy name. I repent, renounce, and break every curse of child sacrifice, ritual sacrifice practiced by my ancestors. I break the curse of the sacrifice of the firstborn child in the family. I repent, renounce, and break the curse of all abortions in my ancestral line and my life. I break the resulting curses of miscarriage, crib death, sudden infant death, and stillborn babies. I sever every soul tie with any life lost. In the name of Jesus Christ the Nazarene, I commit the spirit of every child whose life was taken, in my ancestral line, to the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. I loose everyone in my family line from familiar and human spirits resulting because of these uncommitted souls. I renounce and break the power of any spirit of death and grief inherited through abortion, miscarriage, and Freemasonry. I bind those spirits now, and command them to loose me, and go to pit in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus, I ask you to heal my body, soul, and spirit from the effects of these deaths. I repent, renounce, and break the curse from Freemasonry oaths of vengeance and retaliation from occult covenant relationships. I renounce all seduction of martial arts, judo, and karate, etc. I declare, it is finished in the name of Jesus Christ. Swearing, cursing, and blaspheming. I repent, renounce, and break the curses of blasphemy, cursing, swearing, uncontrollable swearing and taking the name of the Lord in vain, resulting from Freemasonry blood oaths. I repent, renounce, and break the curse of all ungodly language and blaspheming the blood of Jesus Christ with words like bloody, bloody hell or my bloody oath. I declare I am a person of pure speech, who speaks God's word. I will speak blessing and not cursing in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I ask you, Father God, to cleanse my lips with a live coal from your altar in the name of Jesus Christ. Let God touch your mouth now. Control and domination. I repent, renounce, and break the curses of love of power, position, and money resulting from involvement in Freemasonry. I repent of a spirit of pride and break all ties to a spirit of Jezebel and control, domination, and manipulation. I renounce and break all curses of bondage and intimidation that has held my ancestors and myself, through fear and vulnerability, in Freemasonry. I break the power of that helplessness in the name of Jesus Christ. I renounce Freemasonry perfectionism and the lodge of perfection and destroy the false key to heaven, the perfect life. Lust, seduction, and uncleanness. I renounce the idolatry of man. I repent, renounce, and break every curse of Freemasonry idolatry and uncleanness, lust, seduction, adultery, secret affairs, homosexuality, bestiality, sodomy, perversion and immorality from my ancestral line and myself. I break all ties between my family line and the spirit of Antichrist and Jezebel that have operated through seduction and lust. I close the doors in the spiritual realm and break the curses. I bind the strongmen of seduction and lust and send them to the pit. I loose my family line, and declare the spirit of holiness and righteousness rules my life, marriage, home, and family line in the name of Jesus Christ. The God of winter, season of death. I renounce Typhon, the God of winter, and all its effects. I renounce violent death, and conspiracy from my ancestral line and myself. I renounce all soul ties with Typhon and break the curses and resulting dismemberment, fracturing and shattering of health, life, relationships, personality, soul, finances, and in every area of life. I do this in Jesus Christ's holy name. In the name of Jesus Christ the Nazarene, I call my body, mind, soul, and spirit into alignment with the perfect plan and will of the Ancient of Days for my life. Financial problems. I repent, renounce, and break the curses of financial destruction because of Freemasonry involvement by my ancestors or myself. I break every curse on finances that comes with Freemasonry's rings and gods. I renounce and break all generational curses of poverty and I claim restoration of wealth and resources stolen from my ancestors by the enemy. I command Satan to restore 7 times what was stolen now, in the name of Jesus Christ. I break all curses of bankruptcy over all relationships, partnerships, and marriage coming from Freemasonry covenants. I renounce and break the power of all Freemasonry curses, passwords, signs, symbols, allegories and codes off my ancestral line, and myself in Jesus Christ's name. I break the power of the curse of the Freemasonry poor box. I repent and renounce giving away my blessings and assets and feeding and giving to people under witchcraft manipulation. Employment and relationships. I repent, renounce, and break the curse of continual hard labor because of ancestral involvement in Freemasonry. I break the curses over employment and personal relationships for the following: losing favor in any area. Rejection coming from Freemasonry favoritism. Exile from home, family, job, and country. Humiliation because of oaths and rituals. Takeover spirits in employment, finances, and position in the church because of Freemasonry curses and the resulting pain and humiliation of loss. I renounce and break the power of the curse. I am helpless, ignorant, blind, naked, and give away my freedom, manhood, and conscience. I destroy every curse of nakedness, vulnerability, and no covering. I declare I am clothed and covered in Christ. Is 61:10, Rev 19:8. I renounce and break the Shriner's philosophy to have fun. I declare that all ties to Freemasonry and Baphomet has been broken for my ancestors, descendants, and myself, and there shall be no more curses. I do all this in the name above all names, the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Amen. Additional information on Freemasonry connected to the Kundalini spirit, the ancient serpent one, the tree of life of Freemasonry is wicked. It defiles the precious from the tree of all fruitfulness. That fruit produces death. Freemasonry is an alliance with all false religions, including Hinduism, Islam, and Buddhism. Freemasonry states that all religions are acceptable. This is not just empty boasting. There are in fact covenants that provide protection for demons. If you are trying to evict a demonic intruder who is resistant, it may be that there is a covenant providing protection for that evil spirit. If there is an unholy alliance between jealousy and death, the victim spirit, or Freemasonry, a lot of time could be spent commanding, rejecting and renouncing, without result, because their unholy alliances do indeed afford the demons some level of protection. A covenant that was voluntarily entered into by two parties is allowed to stand, regardless of the pain it causes one party or the other, unless there is a law that supersedes it. Similarly, there are ancient generational covenants that were made voluntarily at some point, and they provide a measure of protection for the demons in an individual's life. However, those covenants are subject to the higher law of the universe. Any individual can appeal to the righteous judge of the universe on the basis of those covenants not being just or righteous according to the supreme law that God has established. 1. For a more in-depth discussion and prayer of renunciation on the Kundalini spirit, see the Tree of Knowledge and the Ancient Serpent available from Canon Ministries. Then, if God agrees that those covenants stand in violation of His law, He declares them annulled. That removes the protection the demons once had. Once the unholy alliances and the covenants of protection have been annulled by God, we proclaim that the individual has voluntarily entered into a blood covenant relationship with Jesus. We proclaim that this covenant transcends and supersedes every other covenant, agreement, or protection. We must be determined to separate the vile from the precious, the kingdom of light from the kingdom of darkness. This is the true mandate for the priesthood of Yeshua. The Kundalini is vile. It produces death and it will kill the body. The Masonic cable toe is symbolic of the serpent Kundalini. In the first degree, it affects the Ida, or feminine aspects of the force, thus making it easier for the person to control passion and emotions. In Freemasonry, it coils as the cable toe around the neck. In the second degree, it is the Pingla, or masculine aspect, which is strengthened in order to facilitate control of the mind. In this degree, the cable toe Kundalini coils over the right arm and upper torso. In the third degree, it is the central energy itself, the Sushumna, which is aroused, thereby opening the way for the influence of the pure spirit on high, Lucifer. In this degree, the cable toe Kundalini coils three times around the waist. The Masonic cable toe, symbolizing the serpent / Kundalini, it is passing through this channel of the Sushumna that a Freemason leaves his physical body at will, astral travel, in such a manner that he can retain full consciousness on higher planes and brings back into his physical brain a clear memory of the experience. This is often the root of false visions and experiences. The method devised by Lucifer in the garden is mirrored in the methods being used in the first 3 degrees of Masonic initiations. The 33 degrees of Freemasonry connects to the 33 bones of the spine. The initiation into Freemasonry is done by first activating the woman feminine Ida channel, then the man, masculine Pingla channel, then the contact with the pure spirit, Lucifer, through the Sushumna, which is the human spine, the tree. It is exactly the same pattern used by Lucifer, first Eve, then Adam, then both their eyes were opened, enlightenment. The Ida and Pingla are called nadi, nerve channels in the human spine. If the knot of a Masonic apron is tied, it activates the Kundalini power which is passed on from generation to generation. The blows to the head in Freemasonry takes over the head and mind. Freemasons, the hierarchs of fire, refer to it as the dormant fire, the Lucifer spirit, which is kindled into light by friction, by the blow of a hammer, or by chemical reaction. In Freemasonry there are 7 chakras, 4. The heart chakra 5. The throat chakra 1-6. The brow chakra William the 4th 7. The crown chakra. There are 7 steps into the Masonic Lodge. Understanding the Lewis Stone and the Lewis Curse 1. The firstborn son of a Freemason is known as a Lewis. 2. Another meaning of the Lewis is the apparatus that gets pushed under a heavy stone block to be able to lift it or move it. 3. The stone in the middle of a built arch is also known as the cornerstone and the Lewis stone. How is this arch built? When a stonemason builds an arch, he uses supports to keep the stones in place while it is still uncompleted. The chiseled stones get cemented together from both sides, working towards the center. As soon as the cornerstone is placed in its place, the supports can be removed and the arch stands on its own. Why the cornerstone, as well as the oldest son of a Freemason, is called a Lewis? For many centuries in Persia, they built an archway where the false messiah, Baal-Berith, was placed in the middle of the arch. He was portrayed as a sun on a rainbow. The Lewis stone is placed at exactly the same place. During the Christian era, this false messiah was wrongly associated with the true Jesus Christ. In their search for enlightenment, the Freemasons climb up Jacob's ladder according to the degrees of Freemasonry, until at last they are enlightened when they get to the 31 to 33 degrees. It is at this stage that the Kundalini serpent has climbed through the 7 chakras on the spine, 31 to 33 vertebras. According to the Freemasons, at this stage, they are changed into so-called gods. This in turn, causes the eldest son of the Freemason to be a son of God. He sits in the middle of the rainbow, which is the symbol of the covenant that God made with Noah, as the Messiah. If this so-called Messiah does not take up his calling to be a Freemason, he comes automatically under the Lewis curse. He will never be successful in his life, he will always be struggling with financial problems and will forever be a failure. Praise God that Yeshua is our Messiah. Baphomet renunciation. I repent and renounce all invoking of the psychic power of any deity in my family line, in ritual, and in the foundations of Freemasonry. I renounce all Masonic alliance with Hinduism, and any other group with Kundalini, and release the sword of the spirit to all alliances and declare total division to the alliance with Freemasonry and Kundalini to cripple us. In the name of Jesus I break every alliance with magic in the 9 parts of my body. Cut up and divide the idolatry of 7 steps and the 7 chakras of I renounce and repent of taking the 7 steps into Freemasonry. Father, I renounce the 7 chakras of Freemasonry in prophetic signs in the body to open every seal of the 7 chakras. I repent of the actions of the Master Mason and I rip up the foundations of Kundalini in Freemasonry in my life and ask that you will replace them with the foundations and true healing power of Jesus. I renounce and break the strong parallel of 33 segments of the vertebrae and the 33 degrees of Freemasonry as a total takeover of the entire spinal cord to destroy the body through fire. I renounce and repent of Mother Earth / nature as the false Holy Spirit and the blasphemy of Freemasonry to make allegiance to a false Holy Spirit. I repent and renounce the false Holy Spirit, false anointing and hatred of the true Holy Spirit from the Masonic Kundalini Spirit. I declare the fifth Masonic seal be closed to stop the flow of Kundalini fire of Master Mason's occult, which is satanic fires of hell and magic burning in my throat to destroy my throat, vocal cords, neck, bronchial tubes, thyroid glands, my communication, and releasing the poison of the cobra to my voice to destroy others and the true prophetic calling of God. In the name of Jesus, I cut every part of my body loose that is connected to every planet, my pineal gland from Mercury, and the metal Mercury, my pituitary gland from the Moon, and the metal Silver, my pharyngeal from Venus, and the metal Copper, my cardiac plexus from the Sun, and the metal Gold, my solar plexus from Jupiter, and the metal Tin, my prostate/vaginal area from Mars, and the metal Iron, my sacral plexus from Saturn, and the metal Lead. In Jesus' name, I cut every soul tie with every demonic entity representing themselves as angels, Raphael, Galnel, Ahel, Michael, Zadkiel, Kamael, Chskiel. I declare their hold on my life is broken. All deception has been exposed in Jesus' name. I cut myself loose from the constellations, Aquarius, Scorpio, Taurus, and Leo, with the sword of the Spirit, and I call back any parts of myself that are still stuck on these planets and constellations to be restored to me, in the name of Jesus. I cut my head loose from Scorpio, I cut my navel loose from Leo, I cut my neck loose from Taurus, I cut my kidneys, bladder, and all water in my body loose from Aquarius. I ask you, Father, to restore all that belongs to me, send your angels to gather up any parts of my spirit that has been scattered through astral travel to these seven planets and four constellations, in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, I also cut off the collar and cable toe that comes through demonic curses made by Freemasonry on my bloodline, causing me to be a slave of sodomy through the rituals done to me during initiations. Father, I also renounce the whip, the shackles, and chains that go with being a slave of prostitution. Destroy these with your fire, Father. Father, I bring before you any Masonic temple prostitution on my bloodline. I ask forgiveness for presenting my body as a living sacrifice to demons to be used in this way, in Jesus' name. I call down the fire of God to destroy every satanic altar and idol that is still standing in the spirit and testifying against me, in Jesus' name. Lord, please silence the voices from my past and cut me free from any hooks, chains and pulleys that will try to pull me back into this type of lifestyle. Father, if there is any programming done in the heavenlies, written in the planets, stars, and constellations prophesying against me because of the agreements made with Freemasonry by my forefathers, blot it out now with the blood of the Lamb. And sodomy too, Freemasonry. Freemasonry is a brotherhood for men only, excluding women, which creates separate camps men/women. There are also exclusive women's groups of Freemasons, namely Easter Star, Job's Daughters, etc. Added to this foundation, in the top degrees of Freemasonry are the Knights Templars, who move into high degrees of Satanism, specifically the 28th degree. They believe that to have sex with a woman is degrading and will make them effeminate. Studying the top structures of the Nazi parties, we learn that many of them were homosexuals. The book called The Pink Swastika 3 opens up a lot of truth as to what was going on in the top ranks of Hitler's leadership. The same Nazi spirit was brought into South Africa as the superior race which formed the foundation of apartheid. Today they have approved homosexuality in the traditional Dutch Reformed Church, who years ago justified apartheid from the Word of God. The Knights Templar dress in medieval costumes and worship a mysterious idol called Baphomet. This idol is half beast and half man. The Templars who worship this idol practice black magic, homosexuality and obscene kissing. The father-son relationship in Freemasonry, the father of the temple brings forth the spirit of the Antichrist and death. Antichrist 2. For a more in-depth discussion on sodomy and sexual abuse and a prayer of renunciation, see book available from Canon Ministries, The Defiled Bride, Sodomy and Sexual Abuse. 3. The pink swastika homosexuality in the Nazi Party. Scott Lively and Kevin Abrams. http://www.abidingtruth.com. The Bible teaches us in the last days a man of lawlessness will be revealed, who is the son of doom, the son of perdition. The Freemason family line is bound by the son of perdition. Perdition, perdition alumi, Greek, dash to destroy utterly. The loss of well-being. To overflow completely, especially in the sense of slaying, and to make havoc of. Subject one to foolish lusts, and then sink back in unbelief. There are many gods of Freemasonry. They are worshipped for power, fame, wealth, prosperity, favor, and much more advantages if you sell your soul to them. This is a warning. Those who desire to be rich, fall into temptation and a snare and into many foolish and harmful lusts that plunge men into ruin and destruction. The fruit of Freemasonry. The serious repercussions of the Knights Templar and this homosexual god will visit the generations with death. 1. Over the body, for example, plagues of death over the uterus and prostrate areas with a curse from the Baphomet phallic god, and the curse of sodomy and bestiality. Bowel and colon cancer have a strong spiritual tie to sodomy, and perverted anal activity is often associated with this filthy Masonic idol and practice. AIDS, acquired immune deficiency syndrome. AIDS is the plague that follows sodomy. Weakened immune systems bring terrible weakness and exhaustion. In some cases, extreme fatigue can be the result if it is linked to sodomy in the family line. Baphomet 2. Over our sexuality. The despicable lie of this Baphomet god is an assignment to destroy sexual identity, confuse and twist godly purity and sexuality. The spirit of sodomy with Freemasonry must be destroyed in our lives, and then we need to break the chains off our children and release them into the holiness of the Lord. Ask the Holy Spirit to reveal to you if it affects your personality or your outward appearance, the way you dress, etc., or any ungodly bonding in friendships. 3. Over our marriage. First of all, it will manifest as seduction, lust, and uncleanness, but then a shutdown and a wall of silence in the intimacy of marriage will follow to bring death, destruction, and even insanity into the marriage. Foundation of Freemasonry and sodomy. Christian marriages need to declare war on the roots of sodomy, so that the glory of the Lord can be restored to our marriages.